We wanted to talk about Andrea Mantegna's fabulous painting, Saint Sebastian. It's an early Renaissance painting, and Mantegna is interesting because he comes from central Italy, but marries actually Jacopo Bellini's daughter, Giovanni Bellini's sister, and becomes really enmeshed in the Venetian tradition. He spends time in Padua.
And we see all that Venetian interest in color and in nature here.
Sebastian, by tradition, of course, by legend, is martyred by arrows for his Christian belief. But, you know, if you look at the body, you have this exaggerated contrapposto, this S-curve.
I think it's remarkable for the early Renaissance because it really predicts the elegance and the complexity of the body that we see in the High Renaissance.
The arrows are here used, I think, almost as a kind of diagram
of the body.
Of the body and of its movement. It almost becomes like a line drawing of diagramming the movement of contrapposto itself. If you look at all the arrows in the waist, it really shows the alternation of the hips and the knees, all of those sort of skewed angles.
Mantegna in this image, I think, really takes a step beyond Masaccio and Donatello in terms of representing a really elegant and complex contrapposto.
Now, the body is front and center, but the body is also a kind of relic here, just like all of the ruins of antiquity that are surrounding that body. What we're really looking at is this early fascination with the classical tradition and what it means to revive it.
I mean, we've got all these fabulous ancient Roman ruins.
But in a sense, Sebastian is also an ancient Roman ruin here. Because, you know, what's happening is the antiquity's love of the human body, of its beauty, of its mechanics, is being really celebrated here. And so it's a perfect backdrop to see the ruins of classical architecture. But, you know, there's a really funny kind of anachronism here. That is something that's a little out of joint in terms of time, which is, if Saint Sebastian, who was martyred by the Romans, is being martyred here, then why are the Roman buildings in ruins? It's a curious little thing, isn't it?
It is curious. I guess I've always read that symbolically.
It is, I think.
Absolutely. The way that the Christian is built on the ruins of the ancient Roman pagan empire, posing of the new order, the new Christian order, as opposed to this
I think that's exactly
ruined old order of the ancient Greek and Roman culture.
I think that's exactly right. And here we have the Roman culture, which had ruled the known world for 500 years, and yet Christianity here is transcendent. Christianity has outlived even the power of ancient Rome.
Right, and no matter what you do to its saints and martyrs, you pierce them, you burn them, you skin them,
it doesn't matter.
Their faith remains.
In fact,
Christianity
it's stronger.
Endures.